Hi, my name is Yona, and today we'll talk about masks in Lightroom. So Lightroom bases, masks. Using masks is what takes your editing in Lightroom to another level. If you're not using masks, you don't really know the potential of Lightroom, and you might be one of those people saying that, oh, I can't really do much in Lightroom, which is false. I'm going to show you how much you can do in Lightroom using masks. So if we have not met before, my name is Ivona Podlasinska and you will find me on Instagram and on Facebook and also on my website ivonapodlasinska.com. Here on this channel you will find lots of videos where I show how I use my products from my website on other photos to add a little bit of sparkle magic to all the photos. But today I will just show you how to use masks, and I'm a huge believer in masks. I use masks in all of my photos. I always start in Lightroom and I always add masks, and this is actually what I do first. I know a lot of people are starting with all those sliders, but I have like a different approach and I like to approach a certain parts of the photo separately. So masks are the basis of my technique. And I'm going to take you through all the masks now and show you what they do, how they work, and give you my personal opinion on how I would use those things. So if you have not created any masks yet, you will find this to be the first tab that you can get. And the first one here says object. So subject. You can select the whole person. In that case, it's going to select the girl and the cat that she's holding. Even didn't include the table that was in front of her. And then with every mask, what you do is just you apply things where the mask is. And by default, it starts with the red color. It shows where the mask was applied. By the way, you can change that color to any color you want by clicking here. It was this red, and then you can change any other color. I find red to be really the best. And also you can change the opacity. You can have it a little more or less visible. And and it can show you the affected area or the unaffected area, which for my opinion doesn't make a lot of sense, but it's an option. And this is also a color overlay mode, which is for me again the most reasonable one, but there are other ones. So you can see that on a black and white background. You can have it have this image without the color, but just color, have her selected and the rest of the background is now black and white. She can be on black, she can be on white, and she can be just white on black. So depending on what you like, I always use the default setting, which is the red layer mask on just a regular background. And once you move any slider, then the red disappears and then we can see what you're actually doing. So the first mask that I created was I asked Lightroom to just select the subject. And you can also change the name of that mask, because by default it just creates mask number one. You can double click on this one and just type in whatever you want. So it's a girl. And from that mask, we may also add or subtract, or we can do like an intersection. But let me show you a couple of other things before we get to that adding and subtracting. So once you created your first mask, if you want to create another one, what you need to do is go up here where it says plus and then click that plus. And you can also select sky, which is possible. I don't have a sky in this image, so I'm just going to skip that. You can imagine what it means to select sky. Then we have select background. So it's going to select the opposite from the girl. And again, you can do stuff to the background. You can make, for example, let's make it more blue. Then the next mask I can pick is select people. And this is the mask that I use the most often. I also have a video here on the YouTube channel where I created a preset using all those masks created by Lightroom with select people. Let me just click on it so I can explain better. So first, when you click select people, it shows you what people there are on the photo. And this is one person here. And it's getting better and better because remember at the beginning, it did not recognize faces. Sometimes it did not recognize people, but it's getting better and better. And now we have picked the entire person, but you can also create masks of specific things. For example, we can choose facial and body skin together and create one mask with that, or you can create two separate masks like so. And I'm going to click this and this and create one mask for both of those. And I'm actually going to reduce the texture so it kind of softens her face. And if you wish, you can always go back and, for example, select her eyes using those two masks and create another one. And in this case, we can actually bring those things up to make them sharper. You can always rename those just so you know later what those masks did. But if you just hover over, it's just going to show you the red overlay, and then you can just basically guess what that mask did. And there's also another one, which is objects. And then you can choose a specific thing. For example, I want to pick only the cat from this photo. So I'm going to click objects and then paint on that cat, and it should select the cat's head in that process. And it pretty much did, but in just with a little bit of exception, because it also selected a little bit of her hair. But that's great because we can also subtract or add to the mask. So for example, let's click add, and then we have the next mask, which I wanted to show you a little later, but let's just click this one. So that's a brush, and brush is a brush. I guess like most people would kind of figure out what a brush is. But the important thing about it is that the brush can have a size, feather, flow, and density. Well, size, you know what size is. Then we have feather, which is the softness. Like if the feather is bigger, the brush is going to be more soft on the edge. If it's smaller, it's going to be harder. Then we have flow. Flow means that if the flow is 100, then when we paint all the effect at one stroke. If we have lower flow, we have to paint a couple of times in the same spot to get the full effect, which is great if you're trying to create a very soft edge of a mask. It's better to paint a couple of times in a kind of like gradually add and add and add and build it up rather than slapping the whole thing at one stroke. So I'm going to show you right now, I'm actually subtracting from this mask with a brush, and in this case I'm going to use a lower feather, and then I can I'm actually adding. No, that's not what I wanted to do. I'm to subtract with a brush, and then I can subtract from this mask. So it works like an eraser. You know what? Let me just show you on the brush once again. So we've got the brush and we've got the flow. So if the flow was 100, then if I paint everything with one stroke. But if I have the flow, or if I paint with one stroke, but if I have the flow lower, then I actually have to paint a couple of times in the same spot to get the effect, but then I'm able to create a softer edge. That's why I like to use a flow around 50, start with that, and then if I feel like I need more, then I can move that flow up or down. Brush also has an eraser option. And so you can erase from that. Of course, you can go and use the subtract option, so to subtract from a specific mask. But with brush, you can also go to erase here, and then it turns into an eraser tool, and then you can erase. For example, I'm going to show you with a bigger flow, and then I can erase from this. The quicker version of that is when I paint, and then I click Alt or Option on my keyboard, holding that I paint, and this turns it to an eraser temporary, and if I just let go of that Alt key, it goes back to a brush. So this is how I use it most of the time. If I paint in and that's not what I wanted, then I just basically click Alt on my keyboard and then take that off that part. And another thing here is linear gradient. Let me zoom out to show you the linear gradient. This is, I think, very easy tool. So the lightning gradient works like that. If we have a great lightning gradient, you have to go what you have to do is just click and drag that. So it's going to apply the filter here, and from that line it will start disappearing, and it will disappear in that direction. So after this line there will be no filter added. You can make it harsher, you can make it softer by just basically dragging this up and down. And then if we apply something, it's going to apply where the red color was. And then there's a next one, which is gradial gradient. So it creates like a circle or an oval. You can change the shape like that. And if you just hover over here, you will see like two arrows in like a round shape. And then you can just turn it around. You can make it bigger. And there are two ovals at the moment. So once the smaller one is in the middle, and if you make it very, very small, then the whole filter is going to be very soft. And if you move it up to join the other one, it's going to be a very harsh filter. So let me show you. If I just brighten this up, you will see the edge of that filter. So it's the same thing as feather here. So if I move the feather up, it's going to be very soft. And if I move the feather down, it's going to be a harsh edge. Another thing that you can also duplicate those. So once you right click on it, you create another one here. And from those, of course, you can also subtract, for example, with any option you want. For example, I can subtract from this using a select subject, and it's going to subtract from those two filters that I created in that mask number five, just subtracting the subject. So it gives you a whole range of possibilities when it comes to editing. You can add here, subtract, you can create all those different things in different parts of the image. You can have like your subject, and then the background is going to be brighter just because you create like a radial filter, and then you subtract from the person, and it's going to create like a halo around the person. This is one example that comes to my mind, but of course that's very useful when doing all your retouching, because you can select the skin, you can select the eyes separately. So there are two other masks that I barely ever use. Those are color range and luminance range. Let me just jump into another photo with a little more color, so it's going to be easier to show you. Okay, so I got this image which is a little more colorful. It has two colors. The one is blue on her jacket, and there's probably a little bit of blue in the back in the sky as well, and got some yellow in that field. And if we have those masks, and we can select color range, and if I click on the color range, it's going to select everything that's yellow. And you can add to this selection by clicking shift and clicking on other colors, and it's going to select more colors. Then we've got refine. So we can get this refine smaller or bigger, and you can see what's going on here. If the refine is smaller, the edge is more harsh, and if the refine is higher, it's going to create a softer edge over here. And then you can just do other things to those selected areas, like for example brighten up and maybe add some saturation, maybe remove saturation if you wish to. And there's another one which is luminance range, very similar, but in this case it's actually picking up a certain luminance. So for example, if I'm trying to pick only those dark parts here, I'm going to click here, and it's going to select the dark parts of the field, including her. And here you can see a luminance range diagram, so it shows you what's been selected. So you can limit that to get only the darkest of the shadows, and you can limit that even more around here. That the first one is just what it's picking, and the other thing is like a feathering of that. So the bigger the feathering, the more it's going to pick, but the softer the transition from the softer the edge of that filter will be, but at the same time more will be selected. And for example, you can add some like saturation to those like darker areas here, like less or more saturation to, for example, to the shadows. I barely ever use those last two ones, so color range and luminance range, to be honest. Like in my work, I use mostly brush I used as select people, select objects if I want to do something specific. Sometimes if I, for example, someone is wearing a scarf and I want to change the color of the scarf, I will pick that with the object and then change the color. I have one of those short videos on how to change a color, something in Lightroom, and you can check that out as well. So I'm going to show you one last thing before we say goodbye. That if, for example, I'm going to create a radial gradient and say I want to have this. I want to have this weird line. I know that it doesn't make sense, but I just want to show you how it works. And I actually want to have this weird line over here, but I don't want this to be on the background as well. So I can have intersecting part of the girl and that filter by clicking. So on the mask number 4, which is this radial filter, I have to click holding option. I have this intersect option, and then I'm going to select subject, and now the filter that I just created, this radial filter, is going to be only visible on where the girl is. So that may be sometimes useful. I think I did use it a couple of times. If I, for example, if I wanted to like brighten up a certain part of a person. So let me show you another example. So for example, I brushed up over here and I thought like I want to actually have the front of the girl brighter and the back darker, but of course I didn't want to be on the background as much, so I could just go to intersect and intersect that with a person, so that's going to have that brush visible only on the girl and not on the background. But of course the other way to do that would be to brush that in and then subtract that from the background. So many options. And once you master those masks, I think that you should take your images to the next level. I do that a lot. So I will edit different parts of the image individually, creating those kind of like darkness and brightness, and adding here color and removing color here, just to create like a striking image that grabs people's attention once they scroll. So if you're interested in my editing from A to Z, you can always check my website. I have lots of tutorials for you there. And I'm going to give a link to my website down below. I hope that you like this video. And if you have any ideas of what I can record for you next, let me know in the comments down below. And let me know if you already knew masks in Lightroom or you didn't. I will love to hear from you. Bye.